Here's the diagonalization trick applied to Turing machines. We'll let M1, M2, etc. be the set of all Turing machines. Turing machines can be described with strings, so there are a countable number of them, and so we can enumerate them like this. And we'll create a table as before. I'll define the function fij to be 1 if machine I accepts the description of machine j, and we'll define it as 0 otherwise. For this example, I'll fill out the table somehow. The actual values aren't important right now. Now consider the language L, consisting of string descriptions of machines that do not accept their own descriptions. And let's add a Turing machine, which we'll call ML, that recognizes this language to the grid. Well, again, we run into a problem. This row is supposed to have the opposite values of what's along the diagonal. But what about the diagonal element of this row? What does the machine do when it's given its own description? If it accepts itself, then ML is not in the language, so ML should not have accepted itself. On the other hand, if ML does not accept its string representation, then ML is in the language, so ML should have accepted its string representation. Thankfully, in computability, the resolution to this paradox isn't as hard to see as it is in set theory or mathematical logic. We just conclude that the supposed machine ML that recognizes the language L doesn't exist. Here it is natural to object, well, of course it exists. I just run M on itself, and if it doesn't accept, we accept. The problem is that M on itself might loop, or it might just run for a really long time, and there's no way to tell the difference. The end result, then, is that the language, L, of string descriptions of machines that do not accept their own descriptions is not recognizable. Recall that in order for a language to be decidable, both the language and its complement have to be recognizable. Since L is not recognizable, it's also not decidable. And neither is its complement, that is, the language where the machine does accept its own description. We'll call this DTM, D standing for diagonal. These facts are the foundation for everything that we will argue in this lesson, so make sure that you understand all these claims.